Welcome back to Latest TV News. I'm Yael Elbroya. Mark Walker now catches up with a general consultant surgeon, Goldie Khera, to discuss the new year and mental health.
So I'm here with Goldie Khera, consultant general surgeon at Montefiore Hospital, Royal Sussex County Hospital. We're into the new year, in January, as when a lot of people kind of have a low mood.
Yeah.
Can feel a bit lonely sometimes. So maybe it'd be good to get some advice about what people can do if they do feel that way. And because there's a lot of help available out there, isn't
it? Yeah, there is. And it's honestly, it's such a hard thing to admit to. There's still a stigma attached. There's still people won't admit, you know, almost feel a barrier to saying that. So we see it all the time, and we see, patients coming to see us of all age groups who have loneliness, essentially. And it is kind of such health issues as well. If you're, you know, not eating properly, if you're not exercising, if you're keeping yourself to yourself, for whatever reason, it can have lots of reasons. It can be after bereavement, can be after recovering from an illness. It can just be, you know, social loneliness where you haven't got anybody, friends or family nearby. And to break that cycle, to get out of that rut, is really, really tricky. But I think online now there's help. There's obviously NHS 111, is your GP, and obviously friends and family if they can get a support network. But without that, it's really tricky. And we do see, massive issues from a mental health point of view happening around this time of year, unfortunately. And it's almost as if after the big buzz and the big rush and the expectation that Christmas is meant to be perfect, and when it's not, or, you know, you've had issues, and that's when I think, unfortunately, it can be really difficult for everybody, whatever age group. And we see it, honestly, throughout, both sexes, every single age group, it can happen to suicide attempts, to other aspects where, you know, it's just excluding yourself because you can't see, what you're actually faced with.
Yeah, so where can people get help then? I guess going to the GP's one, but maybe if it's more urgent, is it where at Samaritans, is that one?
Yeah, so it'd be ringing up, it'd be finding help online and ringing up and talking to somebody in Samaritans would be obviously the most famous one. But it's basically just trying to reach out to somebody and making sure that whatever you're doing, you talk about it.
Yeah. Do you get a spike in, bit of an obvious question, but a spike in admissions to hospital, A&E?
We do.
Not just mental health related issues, but other issues associated around Christmas as well.
We do. Right. And it's purely almost as soon as Christmas is over, a big spike in admissions, a big spike in issues with social care, with what patients are facing at home. So it can affect the whole family. So if you have somebody who's got loneliness and therefore depression and issues in that respect, that's going to have an issue for all of their loved ones and their dependents, their family, their partners, their children. So it can have lots and lots of issues almost spreading down in their in their network. So that support network can help at the source, but it can actually work the other way too. So we're trying to break that cycle and trying to help as much as we can. And the main advice I could say really, Mark, is to seek help. So whatever you can do, don't do it alone. Find a friend, find family, find the NHS to help you.
Okay. Good advice, Goldie. Happy New Year. And we'll catch up with you again soon. Thanks for coming.
Cheers.
Thanks.